Subscribe the Unique Academy's YouTube channel and press the bell icon for latest updates and videos.
Hello friends, welcome to the Unique Academy's YouTube channel. In the series of Current Affairs Decoded, today we are going to discuss the topic called as Coronavirus and Health Emergency. So in the recent time, we have seen that World Health Organization, that is WHO, has announced the Wuhan coronavirus that can constitute a public health emergency of international concern. So basically, this public health emergency of international concern is a basic concept which they can ask for the preliminary examination, which is defined by an international health regulation, IHR. Okay. So this international health regulation defines any such type of situation which is generally very sudden in appearance, which is having a serious consequences. It is an unexpected series of events, and this type of health emergency which has a potential for carrying such type of infection or situations that can go beyond a national boundary. Okay. As in the case we are seeing that though it is generated in particularly say China, it is now being spread to different part of the world. And hence, because it is becoming a global phenomena, the actions that are required to contain it or say to take a curative and preventive measures are also of a international concern. Okay. So that is why this is being discussed in the recent time in a different public forum. So even if it is coronavirus that is in news in the recent period of time, we can see that WHO has declared already 5 times such global emergencies, which can also be asked by the UPSC in the coming examination. Okay. These are the emergencies that we can see. They are basically, say, in the recent time, that is what we are seeing is this 2020 ka in coronavirus. Okay. 2018, that is the previous time that we have seen is Zika virus that was originated in the Uganda forest named Zika. Okay. And which has a lot of infections, especially in African countries. 2014 ka Ebola virus is also important. 2014 ka polio declaration is also important. And 2009 ka H1N1 swine flu pandemic is also important. Now you have to also see the difference between pandemic diseases and the diseases which are also considered as a global health emergency. There is a little bit difference between them. You can just find it out. Okay. So basically, when any such type of health emergency is declared as a public health emergency of international concern, it is going to help us in different dimensions. Particularly if we see, say, to boost the public health measures. Okay. Because a lot of countries and organizations will pitch into and will start taking actions like they will provide different resources and funding to develop different type of immediate drugs available that are there. Okay. Or they will take a lot of preventive measures like developing a quarantine zones. Okay. Or developing a different type of identification technique, etc. etc. So this type of global level effect, global level actions will help them if we develop any type of emergency as an international concern. So recently it was also given a code name, that coronavirus, which is named as a COVID-19. Okay. So to remember this particular thing, we can simply consider this thing as a, this CO is given for corona, this VI is given for virus, D is there for disease, and 19 indicates the 2019 when the infection started. Okay. So basically, this type of infection, though start at any particular location, it gets spread because of different reason. Okay. This infection, especially related to coronavirus, even if we see that many of the studies are saying that the infection is started with bats. Okay. The bat is a host of this particular virus. But in the recent period of time, we are also observing that this has been transmitted from not animals to humans also. Okay. And it becomes more of a concern when the transmission is possible between human to human. And that is where the infection starts spreading beyond the regional boundaries to national boundaries to international level. And that is what is being observed, especially when China, which was the epicenter of this coronavirus, has seen a lot of cases, especially in Italy, Iran, now in USA also. In India also, we have identified some of the infection cases. So basically, when this type of viral infection happens to any particular individual, let's say particularly about the coronavirus, it is going to have different type of symptoms on that individual. So this coronavirus, there are different strains of this coronavirus. These different strains are causing different types of symptoms. Out of there are few symptoms that are being seen predominantly. Let's say respiratory syndromes are being quite seen in tandem. So especially one is called as a SARS or severe acute respiratory syndrome. There are a lot of patients that are showing this SARS symptoms. Some of the patients are also showing the symptoms very similar to Middle East respiratory syndrome. Some of them are also having the symptoms which are very, very similar to pneumonia. Now, why it is important to study this different type of syndromes is because this coronavirus, which is spreading across the world in the recent time, is actually having no drug available to treat this particular virus. So whatever treatment is being provided at different health facilities is actually to treat the symptoms. It is also called as symptomatic treatment. So this is actually going to help an individual which is infected to reduce the symptoms that are affecting that individual, so that the person's body and immunity will get a time to improve, and hence it will fight against that pathogen that has entered into the body and will eliminate that particular pathogen. No drug is being given to the individual to treat or to kill that particular viral strain, but it is just to support the immunity system by reducing the different type of symptoms that are happening to that individual. In the recent time also, we have seen Ayush Ministry is also prescribing some of the medicines to treat this coronavirus. So now this was a very debatable issue. Should Ayush Ministry should notify such type of medicine on its website? Basically, these notifications are not talking about treating coronavirus. They are talking about different aspects, like they are also providing them for reducing the symptoms of coronavirus or to, in general, boost the immunity system of the individual so that the infection will not affect the body. But still, the debate is about other issues, like do we have a clinical studies with related to this particular medicine that has been prescribed on Ayush Ministry website. Also, the second point, which is more important, especially in Indian case, is that if ministry prescribes such type of medicine, does it reflect promotion of self-medication? Self-medication is a concept where any individual, without consulting a proper health practitioner, is prescribing medicine to its own according to some of the knowledge that that particular person tries to gain from here and there, especially by reading internet or consulting with the peer group. So this should not happen, because especially self-medication reflects to lot of other consequences which a general person, a common man, cannot understand. Now basically, when this situation is happening, there are also a lot of debates, especially on news channels, and especially if you can go to the All India Radio, where they every day put a spotlight named current affairs discussion, in which they are also having a lot of discussions which talks about, is actually India prepared for such type of global epidemics. So especially related to coronavirus, if we go, we can find out that Health Ministry has already initiated the procedure of Integrated Disease Surveillance Program, through which they will trace the people who are infected and the people who are in contact with this particular person in that particular time period. So because this surveillance program will help to identify such person and will help them to separate out from the masses. As you are aware about that, a person which is affected by coronavirus may take about 14 days to show symptoms. And even if that particular period of time, if that particular person is in contact with another people that may transmit the infection to other people. That's why it is important to quarantine such type of individuals who are infected, and also to check if any such type of person who is in contact with another person is infected or not. For that particular thing, we need to first actually go for different type of steps in which we need to focus on the precautionary aspect of it and also the preparedness aspect of it. Because this is a contagious disease, precaution is going to be the very, very important aspect, in which especially we will focus on the transport hotspot, especially the airports, because it is coming from the other country to India, or say in with respect to other countries. So with this particular case, we will focus on the airports, where we will have a screening program where each and every traveler that is coming from the sensitive zone will be scanned, and if identified as a infected person according to the set criteria by the health practitioner, that particular person will be quarantined and will be checked for different type of test. So in this particular case, they are going to do polymer chain reaction test in the beginning. Okay, so now this becomes very important for prelims perspective. So now after polymerase chain reaction test, if the test comes positive, then they will send that particular sample to National Institute of Virology in Pune. Now this National Institute of Virology also becomes a very important government organization for the prelims perspective, because this is the only government agency that is capable of doing such type of genome sequencing of such type of virus for the final confirmation. Because lot of cases has happened where this particular polymerase chain reaction test has given a negative report, but this particular sense has given a different type of report. Okay, so after taking this precautionary step, okay, we need to go for the other type of steps similar to creating a massive awareness campaign. As in the recent time, they have also started with running a caller tunes on the mobile phones. Okay, so whenever you call somebody, you will first listen to the awareness information related to coronavirus. Such type of effort should be increased. Okay, with that we need to also focus on the different preparedness aspect, especially related to testing that we were discussing. Because as we said, National Institute of Virology is the only organization in India that have this type of genome sequencing wala capacity. We need to establish, as the government recently said, multiple fast track labs to test such type of strains. Second aspect that we need to do about is to keep a sufficient amount of stock to treat the symptomatic treatments, because no drug is available, as you know. So these symptomatic treatment related drugs are going to be very, very important aspect, especially in India, where we are having a very large population. And third aspect that is important for preparedness is to develop quarantine zones, okay, which will having different type of facilities, especially to accommodate large number of people, because the incubation time for this type of viral strain is about 14 days. So some individual is affected by it, has to be kept 14 days secluded from the masses. So these are the different aspects which are going to be there in your examination. From the mains perspective especially, they will also try to ask you different aspects. Okay? For example, they will focus on the earlier international emergencies. Okay? They will also focus on the global health related emergency that was declared WHO earlier, similar to say H1N1 or say Zika or say other things. Okay? So they will say that, is really this coronavirus is that a threat? Okay. So we have to deal with this particular aspect in a both way. First of all, we will say that yes, it is a contagious disease and it is having so and so infectious capabilities, and nowadays human to human transmission is also possible and is now being spread to different part of the world, and deaths are also happening. So it's a serious matter, and hence there is a need to take lot of preventive and precautionary aspect. But we need to compare it with other these global emergencies also. So in that, we will also say that key, for example, the mortality rate in this particular case of say coronavirus infection is about 2% all over. Okay, it will be little bit more in the Western country, especially if we see Italy and USA, it is comparatively more. But still, that is less than the other infections, like in the case of, say, H1N1 and Zika virus, etc. In the second aspect, we will also focus on the point that the number of deaths that happened in the total period of time that has happened for coronavirus is also equivalently less. Okay. Third aspect that we will cover is that it is not only because of the number of infections or the number of deaths that are happening, it is also because of the excessive amount of sharing of such type of news that is trying to create a panic among the masses about this issue. So especially if you see, social media is also creating here a negative contribution in this matter. But we can use the social media as a positive tool in this matter also. We will use social media for generating awareness against this particular issue. So in your mains examination, they will go more for the analysis of such type of health emergencies. It will be also considered as a part of our disaster management, how we will be managing such type of health emergency as a disaster. That is the aspect they will be focusing on mains. In the prelim examination, they will be focusing on the basic aspect, like what they ask in 2015 ka prelims ka question paper is about the simple formula for it. So they have asked about, say, suppose swine flu. In this particular examination, they will ask about coronavirus. That's why you need to know COVID. How is that being explained? Another aspect is that you need to know the basic definition of public health emergency of international concern and the international health regulation that is actually defining this particular thing. What are the criteria WHO use to define it? How many times WHO has already prescribed such type of emergencies, which is actually fifth is this coronavirus, etc., etc. So accordingly, you cover this topic. That is all for this particular topic. Okay, thank you.
The Unique Academy चे नवनवीन वीडियोस आणि अपडेट्स मिळवण्यासाठी लाइक करा, सब्सक्राइब करा आणि शेयर करा.